Welcome back, children. So last class we have discussed about Pythagorean triplet. Our today topic is finding square root of a given number. Finding square root of a given number. Finding square root of a given number by different method. For that, the first way is to find the square root of a number by repeated subtraction method. The first method is the repeated subtraction method. You have to find square root of a number by repeated subtraction method. For that, the previous knowledge required is sum of consecutive odd numbers starting from 1 is n square. Do you remember that? One of the properties in the beginning we have discussed, sum of odd numbers, consecutive odd numbers starting from 1 is equal to n square, where n is the number of odd numbers added. Suppose you are adding 3 odd numbers, 1 plus 3 plus 5, it is 3 odd numbers starting from 1 you are adding, so answer is 3 square, that is 9. Just I am refreshing your mind. Similarly, 5 square, that can be expressed as the sum of 5 odd numbers, consecutive odd numbers starting from 1. That is 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7 plus 9. You will get 5 square. 5 odd numbers are added starting from 1. That concept is very much helpful in this method. Repeated subtraction. Then what we will subtract repeatedly so that we can find the answer, that is square root. That is, you have to subtract odd numbers, consecutive odd numbers starting from 1 from the given number. Okay, that is, you have to subtract 1, subtract 3, then 5, then 7, then 9 from the given number till you are not getting 0. When you are getting 0, you stop there and count how many times you have subtracted or the subtraction process you have applied, and that is the answer. Let us better understand through one example. Find the square root. We use symbol like this. This is square root symbol, children. Square root symbol like this. Find square root over of 16 by repeated subtraction. Find the square root of 16 by repeated subtraction. I have taken small number so that you can easily understand. Given number is 16. You see, this root over sign is also known as radical sign. And the number under the root over is known as radical under radical sign, that is radicand. Together it is known as a sort. It will be taught in class 9, that concept. Just giving you again. Root over square power of 16, you know 4, everyone knows 4. But how we can do that by repeated subtraction? You see, answer is 16 minus 1, 15. The result you are getting 15. Again, from 15 you subtract the next odd number, that is 3. 15 minus 3, that is 12. Result is 12. From the result you subtract the next odd number, 12 minus 5, that is 7. And the process continues till you are not getting remainder 0. Till you are not getting 0, the process continues. Then 7 minus next odd number 5. After 5, next odd number is 7. Here result is 7. 7 minus 7, that is 0. How many times subtraction is carried out? 1, 2, 3, 4 times. That is, 4 times you are subtracting consecutive odd numbers starting from 1 to get a 0. Therefore, answer is 4. Square root of round. Therefore, square root of round 16 is 4. 5. Reason is, reason you write out, 4 times the subtraction is carried out, subtraction of odd numbers, consecutive odd numbers starting from 1 is carried out to get a 0. That's why square root of 16 is 4. Same way, you can find square root of 36, square root of 81, square root of any perfect square number. Okay? But listen children, some limitation of this method is that while doing by this method, it takes more time. It is lengthy. 4-digit, 5-digit number, quite difficult, time-consuming. So try to avoid. If it is given in the instruction, in the question, then only you solve by this way. Second method is finding square root by prime factorization method. All of you know what is the prime factorization. You have to prime factorize the given radicand to find out the square root. That is quite easy. Let us see, as compared to repeated subtraction, that is quite easy, time saving, and within less time you can find the answer. You see, second method is finding square root by prime factorization method. By prime factorization method. And that is quite easy. Suppose someone will tell, find square root of 324. 324 by prime factorization method. What to do? You do prime factorization. You know how to do prime factorization. You take prime factors in ascending order. Do not take randomly. It is individual by some higher prime number. Do not take try from 2. Or it is 0, it is 4, it is divisible by 2. So first prime number you should try 2. Then if it is not divisible by 2, then next prime number 3. Next 5, like that you try. So the first prime number is 2, 162. Then again you divide by 2, it is 81. Again you see 81 is not divisible by 2. You select the next prime number, that is 3. 3, it is 27. Again 27 is divisible by 3. Select 3, 9. Again you divide 9 by 3. Finally, you are getting 1. Till you are not getting 1, go on dividing only with the prime numbers. That is prime factors. Do not take any composite number. As the method is prime factorization, some of you directly write instead of 2 times 2, they directly divide by 4. That is not exactly correct method. As the method suggests, it is a prime factorization. You only allow to take prime factors. So now it is time to write down as a product. The given number can be written as a product of its primes. Okay, after doing this division, then you go for a prime factorization. Write the given number as a product of these prime factors. That is 324, which is 2, 2 times present, 2 into 2, then 3 is present 1, 2, 3, 4 times. 3 is present there 4 times. So write down 1, 2, 3, 4 times. Then put root over sign on both them, both of these number as well as on the products. Then the next important step is that when you have completed this step, then you will go for pairing of equal factors. Pairing of equal factors means if two factors taken at a time and they are paired. Two underline, you underline them, it is easy to identify. Then 2, 3 underline. Another pair of 3 is also there. Then next step is to put equal sign. Out of a pair, only one number will be taken. Out of 2 twos, only 1 2 will be taken. That is the meaning of square root. Out of 2 equal factors, under the radical sign, only one factor should be written and multiplied with the other factors to get the result. 2 into 3 into 3. So answer is 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 3 6. 6 into 3 18. That is quite easy, children. Okay. In this way, you can find out square root by prime factorization. It may be a small number, it may be a very big number, no problem. But you have to take prime factors in ascending order, and out of 2 equal prime factors, you take one factor outside the radical sign, and in the result, do not give radical sign. Do not write your radical sign. That is the answer. Radical sign should be present over the number as well as the prime factors only. Next step, do not write radical sign. That much concept for this prime factorization as well as the repeated subtraction. That is, you have to find square root by these two processes. Then the third process, third method is by division method, which we will be discussed in the next class. Then we will write down, children. You please write down, quickly write down, children.